Hello everyone, I am Huawei instructor Lee Shinyuan. Now I will demonstrate to everyone web configuration method for WLAN Layer 3 side-hanging networking. Our web configuration method is the same as the fourth experiment we discussed earlier. Command line configuration for WLAN Layer 3 sub-interface networking, its topology is the same. So, in this experiment, I will mainly demonstrate to everyone how to configure the AC and AP related settings in the web interface. Configuration of routers and switches. I will selectively skip. Now let's take a look at the configuration. The configuration on switches, SW1 and SW2 earlier. We have already configured it before, so we don't need to reconfigure here. Now let's mainly look at how to configure in the web interface. This is our web interface. We can log into our web interface using the IP of the AC. Of course, we are using the HTTPS protocol. After entering the interface, let's take a look at what this interface looks like. Return to the lab guide first. We need to create VLAN on the AC. VLAN 20 and VLAN 60. Select configuration. Then select IC configuration. There is VLAN configuration on the second line above. There is only one VLAN one now. Then we can add VLAN 20 and VLAN 60. Batch creation can be selected. Now we have VLAN 20 and VLAN 60. This is the first step. What about the second step? We need to assign VLAN to the port. Here we assign VLAN to our first interface. Now let's take a look, similarly, in the AC configuration. Just now, our configuration was VLAN. Now we enter this interface management. We saw some interfaces, now we enter the first interface. Now we can see, the link type is hybrid. In our experiment, we require our link type to be trunk, then pass through VLAN 20 and VLAN 60. Let's configure it. Now we can transparently transmit VLAN 20 and VLAN 60. Confirmed. All right, now let's click in and take another look. Our link type is trunk, then through VLAN 20 and VLAN 60. What about the next configuration? Configuration is performed on the office machine. Create some VLAN interfaces on the core switch. We'll skip this one. We have already seen how to configure it before. Let's take a look. How to configure on the AC. In the web interface, create our VLAN interface. So let's go back to our VLAN options. There is VLANIF in the above table. There is only one default VLANIF1 now. We choose to create a new one. Select VLAN ID VLAN 60. If we want to, you can also add a port description. We use IP 10.60.1. Then the 24-bit mask. All right, then click OK. Now we can see we have set up a VLAN interface, VLAN 60. After this step is completed, we also need to set up our AC loopback interface. How should this loopback interface be configured? In our interface management, find the Layer 3 logical interface in the logical interface. Go to interface management, then find the logical interface. So we have the second layer logical interface and layer 3 logical interface. Let's locate the layer 3 logical interface. It's empty now, so we choose to create a new one. The interface type and change are loopback, so we can choose 0 as our code. It's loopback 0. If you want, we can also choose to describe, then select IPv4. Now let's set the interface address. 10.10.10.10. The subnet mask is 4255s. Okay, now we have obtained a loopback 0 interface. That's how it is. Next, in the configuration of the root, we will also skip directly. Continue reading below. The next step is to configure the AP for online connection. In this networking mode, our DHCP server is located at on top of our first machine exchange. This configuration was just discussed earlier. Let's pass by quickly. Now we need to configure our AC power supply. So we choose in the configuration, select basic configuration, then find loopback 0. Take a look, basic configuration in AC configuration, then use loopback. Select a loopback. It's our loopback 0. It has been added now. After adding that, we choose Applications, Operation Successful. Now we have added the source address for the AC. What is the next step then? Need to create an AP group, because we have more than one AP. So we need to create an AP group. This AP group can be named as Huawei. First, let's locate the AP group. Where to create? AP configuration, AP group configuration. Select new. Let's take a look. We need to use the name Huawei. After confirming, creation completed. Now we have this AP group from Huawei. Next, we need to configure the AP. We need to enter the AP configuration interface. Then find the AP configuration, add AP. Okay, add AP. We need to find the MAC address of the AP. We have found the MAC address of the first AP. After adding, we named our first AP as AP1, named the second AP as AP2, AP1, AP2. Then select OK, execution successful. So now, we can see two APs have logged in. Now moving on, we need to access this AP, change the parameters of the AP. Join the AP group first, Huawei, confirmed. The second one, modify in the same way, join the Huawei AP group. Now let's go back and check the status of the AP. Currently, the state of our AP is idle, the AP has not come online yet. First of all, we need to add a route on the router. Route to 10.10.10.10. Let's see if this router is available now. Let's take a look. The next hop to 10.10.10.10. is 10.60.1. This route already exists. Then, we also need to configure static routes on the AC. Let's take a look at how to configure static routes. IP, find the router. Close the routing table first, then open the static route. Now we need to create a new static route. The next hop address is 10.1.10.0.32550. Then the next hop is 10.1.60.2. That's correct. We click OK. So this route is established. It's already visible. You can go to our trading rack to take a look. Can you confirm if this address is... this address is correct. Now, let's check the status of our AP. Okay, two APs have been successfully connected online. IP address has been obtained, and you can see the model of our AP, 5760-10. Then, you can also view the software version of the AP. Next, we can continue to configure WLAN services. Firstly, we need to configure the template for SSID. In AP configuration, next, we can find the template management. In the AP configuration, template management. Then wireless business can find the template of SSID. In the experiment, we need to create a new employee, new click OK. After confirming, here we also need to set a name for the SSID. Just now was the name of the template. Now we need to set a name for the SSID, click on the application. Now we have finished configuring the first template. What about the next one? We also need to configure a template for the guest network. The operation is the same. Let's configure a new one again. Guest. Continue to set the SSID name as guest. Click on the application. Now we have created guest and employee, two templates. Next, we need to configure the security template. Enter the security template. We use WPA2, PSKAES. This one is also default. Then we set up a secret room, just set one randomly, set this to Huawei, 123. Next, we also need to set up a guest template. For this security template, we directly use open, it's undefended. Just use open directly, operation completed. Now, moving on, we need to enter the configuration of the VAP template. Similarly, in the template management, we need to find the VAP template. Both are created employee. After creation, we need to configure for this VAP template of the employee. We need to apply the SSID employee and the security template employee and tunnel forwarding. Then our business VLAN is 20. Here we need to select a template for the SSID application. Then you need to select a security template. Application, we need to configure tunnel forwarding. Then VLAN after VLAN is 20, then apply, so the configuration is complete. Next, we also need to create a VAP template named guest. Similarly, to reference SSID and security templates. This is done by direct forwarding. VLAN is 30. Directly forward VLAN using 30. Click on the application. Now the template references the VAP template. Success. Now, let's set up the domain template. Locate the domain management template in Video Management. Then click on New, using Huawei as the name. There is already a Huawei here. We can use it directly. Select Application. Now let's return to the configuration of the AP group. Now we have a Huawei AP group. In this AP group, we need to add our VAP template. So, here, we can click on VAP configuration, then click on Add. You can choose from several templates we just created. First, you can select Employee. I typed N instead of M. It's nothing. Select one here. Confirm. Execution successful. Then we need to add the second one. Select Guest. WLAN ID is 2. To proceed with the addition. The addition has been successful now. Next, we will set up the domain management template. We choose Huawei with domain management templates. Then apply. Operation successful. Let's confirm the results below. Let's go back to the monitoring to check our signal. 4 total RF ports. 2 5G networks. 2.4G dual bands. For APs, there are a total of 2. Normal status. So this is how we use the web. Configure WLAN. Thank you all.